On October 2nd, 2018, we made the trip out to Dollywood, dragged behind locomotive 192 on the Dollywood Express. So sit back and relax and enjoy the Dollywood Express train ride.
If there is a true medical emergency, please pull down on the cord for 2 seconds and release. After the cable has been pulled, the conductor will acknowledge that the pull cord has been pulled and will notify the engine crew and EMTs to prepare an emergency response. The train will not stop. We will quickly proceed to the nearest first aid location. Do not pull the cable for lost cell phones, cameras, etc. The train will not stop for these items.
And folks, the cinder in your eye is not considered a medical emergency, so please don't pull the pull cord if you get a cinder in your eye. When we get back to the depot, let any of the conductors know about it. They will direct you to our safety office, where an EMT will safely remove it for you.
The conductor has received our all clear, and we will be pulling out of the depot at any moment. As we get ready to depart, let me remind you of a couple of the safety rules you'll need to know for our trip today. Please remember to remain seated at all times. This does include small children, as they are not permitted to stand on your lap, on the seat, or on the floor. If you have small children in your group, please have them sit in the center portion of your seat with an adult on the outside edges. Also, remember to keep all body parts inside the car at all times, and the use of tobacco products is not permitted during our trip. Thank you.
On the back part of the train, waving goodbye to our depot master, Bob. So Bob will see him in a day or two. A week at the most, but we have never been gone longer than a week. Here at Dollywood, we're known as the friendliest place in the Smokies. Let's all get a hand in the air and start waving. On the count of three, let's let out a big howdy. 1, 2, 3, howdy! Hey, that sounded good. So you keep on waving and being friendly to everybody. I'm going to tell you about this brother piece of history right behind. Over on your right is Dollywood's old-fashioned grist mill. One of the few operating grist mills left today. That's where every day they fresh bake that world-famous cinnamon bread. And I'll tell you, there is nothing better. December the 7th, 1941, came the attack on Pearl Harbor and the United States involvement in World War II. It was determined that a military highway was needed to protect Alaska. So in 1942, the United States Army took over the White Pass and Yukon Railroad of Skagway, Alaska, and used it to move the material and personnel needed to build the Yucatan Military Highway. And it worked on the White Pass and Yukon Railroad. Wow, 180,000 tons of material supplies, along with troops and personnel, travel behind this engine and many engine flights up to 34 trains a day, all in support of road construction. And in only 9 months, what had seemed impossible became possible, as the Alcan Military Highway was completed. I bet you didn't realize you're right behind a true veteran of World War II. Here at Dollywood, we're proud of all our veterans from all branches of the military, and our hopes and prayers are with those on active duty today. She remained at Skagway, Alaska until her retirement in 1960. In 1961, she was sold to an East Tennessee theme park named Rebel Railroad. That's where they eventually named her Klondike Katie. Hey, look up to the engine, wave our engineers. That's Chris up there today. Klondike Katie has been here through the entire evolution of this park, from Rebel Railroad to Gold Rush Junction to Silver Dollar City, Tennessee, and now present-day Dollywood. Present-day Dollywood, where she continues her tradition of hard work. But let's all sit back and relax and listen to the engine as she makes her way up the mountain. Called these mountains the place of the blue smoke. The Smoky Mountains are the natural habitat for more flowering plants and trees than anywhere else in the United States. Even in the air, you can hear the music of over 200 species of birds. The Smokies are a never-ending song. They change with each season and with each pair of eyes. Here at Dollywood, we're real proud of Klondike Katie. So much that sometimes we're there to show off a little bit. What do you say, folks? Would you like to hear the engineer play a tune on that Baldwin locomotive whistle? All right, on the count of three, let's yell blow the whistle. 1, 2, 3. Blow the whistle! about that? How about a big round of applause for Engineer Chris and Klondike Katie? Hey, that's Chris and Klondike Katie saying no problem. Now, if you look out to your left, you can see parts of the Great Smoky Mountains. You can tell why they're called that. They look like that most of the time. Smokies were established as a national park in 1934. They're the most visited national park in the United States. And they do have free admission. At the dawn of the 20th century, there was over 1,200 farms in these mountains. Each one had the main house that the family lived in. It was kind of like this one on your left. They had a woodshed, a chicken coop where they gathered their eggs, a smokehouse where they hung and cured their meat, and a spring house that kept things like the milk and the butter cool. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. They had one other little house. It was called the outhouse. Kids, if you don't know what the outhouse was used for, I'm going to let you ask your parents about it. Or you might have to ask your grandparents. Coming up on your left, soaring 21 stories above the floor of the Great Smoky Mountains, is the Wild Eagle. You'll drop 13 stories as you fly up to speeds of 63 miles an hour. It has a 110-foot giant loop. It might be the most exciting 2 minutes and 22 seconds of your life. How many people has rode the Wild Eagle? How many people are big chickens to ride the Wild Eagle? Oh, the chickens win again. You go in the merchandise shop, they got big yellow t-shirts that says, I'm a chicken. Now it's time for some train folks. Welcome to the engine. Wave to our that's Jimmy up there today. He's the one responsible for getting us all up here by hand shoveling all the coal into the firebox. This engine operates the same way today as it did when it was first built. On a busy day, Klondike Katie will use 5 tons of coal, 5,000 gallons of water, and she'll bring 4,000 to 5,000 people up the mountain. We're real proud of our engine and the guys that operate them. We hope you enjoy riding behind them just as much as we do. Over on your left is Dollywood, is the future home of Dollywood's newest themed area, Wildwood Grove. It will feature 11 new experiences for guests of all ages. It will feature unique attractions and a Southwest-inspired dining establishment. We look forward to having even more to offer you and your family in 2019.
Long late in the evening when the sun is sinking low, you'll hear it in the drive. In the drive,
over on your left's Timber Canyon. It's the home to Dollywood's award-winning wooden roller coaster, Thunderhead. And Mystery Mine, it's a steel roller coaster with high speed, white knuckle loops, and an 85-foot drop straight down a mine shaft. Also up here is Dollywood's newest ride, the drop. It'll take you up 230 feet where you get a great view of everything for a few seconds, and then it drops you. I see the great pumpkin illuminates down there.
Texas special running late, she's got some time to gain. The engineer looks at his watch and kind of grins with pride. He gives the whistle, quarter jerk, and pulls the throttle wide. Texas special, she's long and steep. Her rolling beauty, silver speed. Her whistle's screaming, she don't slow down. For she's a pride of Texas, and she's Dallas bound. Texas special, long and steep. A rolling beauty, silver speed. Her whistle screaming, she don't slow down. For she's a pride of Texas, and she is Dallas bound.
As your car goes through Owens Park, wave at all the people waiting across the tracks.
16 coast of Florida.
Thank you. Well, you're right. This big green building is Dollywood's full-service train shop. That's where a highly skilled engine crew can totally rebuild an engine from the wheels to the smokestack. For your viewing pleasure, Engine 70 is built in 1938. Coming out in a few days, we gather up all your personal belongings, your backpacks, purses, cell phones, cameras, stuffed animals, shopping bags, children. Yeah, please, don't forget the children. If you accumulated any trash along the way, we'd appreciate if you deposit that in the barrels. They're located up and down the boardwalk. If you had your picture taken when you came into the depot, they're going to be ready and waiting for you out there. And if you exit the train, go check out the magic shop. They got lots of magic tricks and practical jokes. So folks, I need everyone to please remain seated. I got a few people on the back that need a little bit of a head start. So please remain seated. Remain seated, please. Remain seated. Remain seated.
If you liked what you saw, subscribe to my YouTube channel and give this video a like.